We went over our riser. Let me go directly to my motor. We build the one, they call it one line diagram for the power system that we have. Cool. And I told you the outcome of this is to achieve the following. We were able to have a one line diagram, a short circuit report, input report, load flow report. You guys did that yesterday. And arc flash labels. Remember how we did the arc flash labels? Now today, what I would like to focus on these ones. I'm going to go highlight them with maybe which color? Blue. We need to do coordination curve for the condensing unit one and the report. Coordination curve for condensing unit two and a report. Coordination curve for air handling unit and a report. Can I? That's the only three I'm interested in. Condensing unit one and two. And coordination curve, and the coordination curve for the condensing unit one and two and the air handling unit. Cool? Everybody understand what we're trying to achieve? Okay, now let's go achieve it. I'm going to minimize this. The first thing we need to do, guys, is we need to go put circuit breakers. So I'm going to go zoom into the generator right in here. This gen, extend the neck of the gen. Can you guys see how extended? Make a neck for it here. Everybody, you're going to see why I make a neck here. Everybody's okay with that? Make it, you can do it like by extending it slightly here. Then we're going to go put a circuit breaker by the generator. Circuit breakers are right here. Can you guys see that? Here's a new low voltage circuit breaker, fuses, different type of fuses. The one that I need, it's called new low voltage circuit breakers. Click on that. Can you guys, you are holding a circuit breaker atom in your hand. All what you have to do is now can go, can you guys see, just go put it over the line right here and click. Now you have just installed the circuit breaker by the generator. Okay, next to it, please double click on the name, and CB, put CP dash gen, GEN, name it circuit breaker generator. See what I did? Very easy, very simple on the generator. Okay. So that's what I'm going to do on the generator side. So that's my generator. Then you can adjust your, look how I'm going to go adjust these, grab them and bring them down slightly so it looks nicer. You know what I mean? You can look at how you can adjust them and make them look nicer. Okay, that's my generator circuit breaker. The second circuit breaker that I'm going to have, I'm going to install Adam. I'm going to assume that I'm going to have my auto transfer switch is going to have a circuit breaker right here. So please make a room here. Can you guys see we're right in here? I'm going to put a circuit breaker. Please make a room. How do you make a room? Move things around up a little bit, move the cable up, have a neck. Do you see what I mean? Have a place where you can put the circuit breaker. Did you guys adjust yours to have a place for a circuit breaker? Then Adam, same thing. Click on circuit breaker. Make sure you have enough room. Make sure you have, if you don't have enough room, it wouldn't connect it. You guys have enough room and go right in here and put your circuit breaker. Same thing, guys. Click on it. Say circuit breaker. And I'm going to say main panel. This is coming to the main panel. Circuit breaker main panel. That's the one that's going to be protecting the main panel. Did you guys see what I did? So I have two circuit breakers. Do you guys have two circuit breakers? One for the gen? Cool. Okay. Let's continue. I can have circuit breakers for all these, which probably you should. So make sure you have neck, you have enough. So look what I'm going to do. I'm going to go pick all these. Can you guys see what I'm doing? Pick them all and drag them down slightly so I can have enough room. Do you see what I mean? Have a neck here for all of them. Cool. And do me a favor, grab your circuit breaker, the same circuit breaker here, and held the control button. Grab a circuit breaker and hold the control button and put one here. Oops, you don't have to hit the control. And put one here. Which one? Shift? Is it shift or control? I thought one of them should be able to. Here you go. Shift. I'm sorry. Shift. And put one here, guys. One here. One here. And one here. Yes, sir.
Did you put a circuit breaker before the ATS?
Yes. Yes, you can put it after or before. We're assuming that the ATS is going to come up. Very good point. We're assuming that my ATS, if you put it after, that's okay. But I'm assuming my ATS is going to come with an overcome protection device as a service entrance equipment. Okay?
So
If you put it after, don't sweat it too hard.
would that breaker actually be in the cabinet with the ATS?
Yes, absolutely. Were you guys able to put circuit breaker on each one of these? Okay, let's go name them. I'm gonna name this one same thing. Name each one of them. CB, each one of them CB guys, and LP lighting. That's for the lighting panel. And this one will be CB dash RP. And just go ahead and name them. This one is gonna be CB dash air handling unit. I'm on this one will be CB dash CU dash one. Can you guys see that? Oops, I'm naming him dash one. So I'm putting circuit breakers ahead of each one of these. Keep going. If I'm going too fast, please let me know. CB dash CU dash two. I'm naming the circuit breaker by the load that they're going to be feeding. CB dash, this is BP dash one. And the last thing, gentlemen, is CB dash BB dash BP dash two.
Chad, I've actually got a problem dropping the circuit breakers. It won't let me drop the circuit breaker.
It will not let you, and save. Make sure you save. Let me see.
So put the circuit breakers as a name and save. So which one is the user is the LP unit?
Low voltage. Just needed to adjust. Okay. Can you guys give me a thumbs up when you're done with all these? Thumbs up. Yep. Kieran, working on Adam. When you guys are done with naming him, need a few. Okay. Good. Just let me know when you guys are done. No rush, nothing. Rush, rush, rush. No rush, nothing. Rush. Okay. I'm waiting for Karen. Good. Derek, working a little bit needed. Okay. You're good? Okay. Matt, good. Adam will be in a second. And Brian, you can catch up with us. You have your own frequency, 355 hertz. Good. Okay. Take your time. Good. Take your time. Okay, I'm not going doing a lot. I'm just talking here. Now, I want to remind you guys, I'm only interested in CU1, CU2, and air handling unit. So I don't want to do coordination for the rest, though we can. I'm only interested in doing these coordination. We typically do coordination for all the circuit breakers. For the sake of the time, I want to only do it for three loads: CU1, CU2, and air handling unit. Everybody understand that? Okay, now to do the coordination, we're going to wait a few seconds and we're going to. Now that we put the circuit breakers, I'm going to go load the circuit breakers with information. So, Karen, every manufacturer of every circuit breaker, low voltage or high voltage or fuse, have a library for all their circuit breakers inside the software. Remember the IES file, guys, that we used to pick up for every fixture? There is equivalent to the IES file for every circuit breaker. So, what I'm going to do me a favor, go to the main circuit breaker right here. Can you guys see that? Zoom in it and double click on the icon itself. Double click so you open the component editor. Cool? On the circuit breaker main. One more time. Here, right here. Double click, not on the name, on the component. Cool? Now, do you see where it says library? Click on library. Remember, we got library for cables. Open, can you guys see that? Here's the library for all the circuit breakers. You guys have it? Expand it. Click on it. Now, here's the library for all the circuit breakers. Okay, cool. I want to assure you guys there are literally hundreds of thousands of circuit breakers and fuses and relays and what's not in this library. You will spend, if you are to work for this one, guys, you spend a lot of time understanding where they are. So I want to make it easy for you. We have a 500, we have a 500 amp service. So I would like to use not static, these are electronic, not GFCI. Can you guys see where it says thermomagnetic molded circuit breakers? Click on this. A circuit breaker, yeah, for the main panel. Yep. So go to the one, the magnetic circuit molded circuit breaker. There is power, there's so many circuit breakers. Which one do you want to pick, Chad? I decided single-handedly, after I bought the material, I'm going to be using Square D. What type of circuit breaker, Chad? I decided single-handedly to use Square D. So click on here, and thermomagnetic. Click on, can you guys see here the manufacturer? Go all the way down to Square D. Can everybody can see that? Here's a Square D. Can you guys see that? Click on Square D. That will give you only the Square D circuit breaker, the thermomagnetic. Everybody can see that? Only Square D thermomagnetic circuit breakers. Can I have thumbs up, Chad? We're there. Okay. Why did I choose Square D, not Kalar-Hammer, not Siemens, not GE? Because the how do you decide which one to use based on the product that you bought when you install the system. So before, when we design it, we have no idea, guys. So you pick one manufacturer, you do it after they purchase the equipment, and you know who the manufacturer is. You go back and recheck, you recalculate. Okay, so now which circuit breaker I'm going to use? Look at all this list. Remember, this is a 500 amp circuit breaker, the one we're picking. So I need a 500 amp circuit breaker 208. So let's see what we can. I'm going to help you with this one. I'm going to go to a circuit breaker. Oops, screwed it up here. Square D again. I'm going to go down to a circuit breaker. Okay, so where did it go here? Okay, where's my circuit breaker? I don't have. Oh, I'm sorry, L. Can you guys see the one that says L, okay. LC. Can you guys see this circuit breaker? I'm going to go to a circuit breaker that says LC300-600. Okay. Why did I pick up this one? Typically, these circuit breaker guys will be picked up by the manufacturer based on the size. But I'm going to go pick up a Square D LC type circuit breaker, 300 to 600 amp. Why? Because my service is 500. That will give me the range of my service. And look at the voltage. The voltage is 600. So up to 600, I'm good. My system is 208, I'm good to go. I probably could have gotten away with, see, this is up to 400, it wouldn't get me. So this one can get me the amps and the voltage. Double click on it, will ya? Double click on it and exit. After, can you guys see that X here? When after you double click on it. Now, yes, sir. Okay, let's go. No, go to the library. Are you under thermomagnetic circuit breakers?
No.
Uh-huh. That's it. Go to thermomagnetic Square D. You should have LC. Everybody else got it? Okay. So it's an LC 300 to 600 amp, 600 volt thermomagnetic. Okay, except. Now, for the rest of you guys, now remember, I'm going to go adjust this one. Here's the series that I have. My voltage is 208, and I need 500. So go find me a 500. Here's my 500 amp, 240. Let me see if I can get smaller than that. So I have 300. We don't need 300. Go to the 500. Can you guys see? Here's my 500 amp, 240, 500, 1,000 interrupting rating. That's the one that you want. 240. Why 240? Because my system is 208. So 208 is close to 40, is too close to 280. So I picked the 240 LC 500 amp, 1,000 K interrupting rating kiloamp. Everybody got that one? Go scroll down. You should have it all the way down. See that little button here? Scroll down. You got it? So it should 200 LC. Now right here, guys, click on this button and make it 500. Everybody can see that little button? So I have 240 LC, 500, 1000K. That's it. That's my circuit breaker. Did you get it, Karen? Okay, good. Everybody change that to 500. Can you see that one from 450 to 500? That's it. Now X that little button here. I want to go now, go to the same circuit breaker, guys. Keep, click, highlight it, right click on it. Copy data. You see what I did? Copy data. And I'm going to go to the circuit breaker for the generator, and I'm going to put the same circuit, same information about the generator, right? They're going to be the same size. Right click on it, gentlemen, and paste. Now, if you did this, do me a favor, open the generator one and make sure that when you go to the settings, make sure the generator circuit breaker shows a 500. Give me a thumbs up if that works for you. Good. You will basically copy the same information about the generator. Gentlemen, we're done. Now we put the information about the main circuit breaker and the generator. Everybody's good with that? Now, I don't care about the all the other circuit breaker. The only circuit breakers that I care about now is, I'm going to go zoom into them, air handling unit. Can you guys see where the air handling unit is? Adam, do you remember what the air handling unit circuit breaker is? Anybody remember what the size of the circuit breaker? Okay, the air handling unit was 208, 15 horsepower, right? So let's go size it quick here. I need to know how the size of it, because you guys, you should find this one from your, you should find it, guys, from your, close that one. Size, minimize, medium. Okay, so I'm going to go change this one into 75. I have a, is it 15 horsepower, right? Was it 15? 15 horsepower. And the voltage is 208 volt. Here's the amps. The circuit breaker, inverse type circuit breaker is right here. Inverse type circuit breaker. So I need 115.5. So that will give me 125 amp circuit breaker, 125 amp circuit breaker. 115.5 can get you 115.5. So what's your next standard? 125. Okay. So I need a 125 circuit breaker. Everybody got that one? 125. Double click on this circuit breaker. Go to the library. Now go to thermomagnetic again. Everybody can see the thermomagnetic. Click on square D. Remember how we went all the way to square D? Right to the top, square D. Now I am thermomagnetic, Brian. Not static, and square D. Okay, the circuit breaker that I'm going to choose, now which one I'm going to choose? Now remember, I need 125. So the one that we chose before will not give me there. Why? Because it doesn't go all the way down to 125. So I'm going to go to a circuit breaker that says KA. Can you guys find me a KA? K. Can you guys see the KA circuit breaker? Everybody can see that? It goes from 70 all the way to 250. Would that cover 125? Yep. Would that cover all the other the chillers? Yep. It will cover the chillers too, because the chiller was 110? The chiller was 110. So double click on the KA. Everybody got the KA circuit breaker? And exit. Okay, now let's go find 125 amp circuit breaker, will ya? 240, 125 amp. So let's go to as close to it. I need here's 100. The next standard is 125. Can you get? So I have 240 KA 150, right? Now click on this and go all the way to 125. Look, do you see guys how I got 125? 240 KA 150, 42 interrupting rating, and 125 amp. Done. Exit. Now here's what I'm going to do, and listen to me carefully. I'm going to go, it's still highlighted, hover over it, right click, copy data. I'm going to go put the same type of circuit breaker, which is typical, the same type of circuit breaker in the following. Click on condensing unit one, hold the shift, and click on condensing unit number two. I'm going to make it, they're both highlighted, right, Adam? Right click on it, and paste. What I did, guys, I put the same type of circuit breaker for both condensing unit one and condensing unit two. Can I have thumbs up, Chad? We got it? Good. Okay. Now let's go double click on condensing unit number one. because I need to change, the type is the same, but the size is different. And go to settings. Now, condensing unit number one, can you guys check that one? It was 110 based on 110. So click on this. Can you guys see that? And change this one to what? 110. So here's my condensing unit number one. Can somebody check condensing unit number two, because I can't remember that. Condensing unit number one, change it to 110 and exit. Exit. Go open condensing unit number two and go to settings. And do you have the, anybody has the, who's the teacher? Are you guys the teacher or am I? I should be ready here. Where did it go? No, they're not the same size. They're not the same size. Condensing unit number two, guys, based on the manufacturer recommendation, should be from the cut sheets. The future condensing unit. Future condensing unit. Future condensing unit. It says 60 amp. We need a 60 amp from the cut sheets. Okay, so did you guys go and open the condensing unit number two? Everybody is, what I did, I went fast. I went back to condensing unit circuit breaker number two, open it. Don't go to the library because it's, you already have a circuit breaker. All what you have to do is just pick the right size. I need 60. Now this will not give me 60. So go up here, guys, and find something closer to 60, all the way back. Oops. These are 100. Thank you. Okay, thank you. So if you go 240, KA 100, and the smallest that you can get is 70. We're stuck with that one. It's going to be a 70 amp. Now, if I want to be too precise, I have to go basically find myself another circuit breaker. That's 60. Should we do that? You guys want to go? Find another type of circuit breaker that can give me 60. But 70 is close enough, guys, for this application. Let's just stop there. Okay, close it, exit. Here's all my circuit breakers are set. Now let's do the coordination. Now you're going to listen to me, guys, carefully what I'm going to do. Typically you would, but not for this project. The other panels, guys, we typically do the same thing. Copy the same circuit breaker and set it up for all of them. Go ahead and do it if you want to, but these are the only required ones for the project. Now do me a favor. I want you to hold the shift button and be very careful. Hold the shift button and pick that generator. Make sure you zoom that you can see the whole thing. Pick the generator circuit breaker. Pick the main circuit breaker. You're still holding the button, right? And I'm going to go zoom a little bit here. Oops, zoom in. And make sure you can see the whole thing. And go to the and pick the air handling unit circuit breaker as well as the air handling unit motor. Can you give me a thumbs up with all these are selected? Can you guys see that? I want to coordinate between the generator circuit breaker, the air handling unit circuit breaker, and the starting curve of the air handling unit. Can I have a thumbs up, Chad? Good. Now, here's how, can you guys see that little icon here? That's how you do the coordination. Everybody can see it? Right here, right here. Okay, now I'm going to go please click on it. You see time current curve, TCC. Call this one air handling unit, AHU. That's the coordination for the air handling unit, right? We only have one, so just call it. And it's new, so hit new, will you? Click on new. Hit yes here. When you get this bind, hit yes. Gentlemen, this is your coordination curve. Can you guys see your coordination curve? Expand it. Can you guys see that? Expand it. Do me a favor. Can you guys see that the bottom is just, it's not showing you the end of that curve? What I would like you guys to go is go settings and TCC settings and add a zero. To add 10 to this max, just basically shifting it, and hit OK. Did you guys add a zero here? Now your curves are kind of, you can see the end of the curves. Everybody can see that? Okay. Now do me a favor. We selected the generator, the main breaker, the air handling unit, and the air handling unit motor. I'll walk you in a second. Okay, now, Start with the main circuit breaker, guys. Grab the main circuit breaker, put it at the top. That's my circuit breaker main. The generator is still the same. Can you guys see the generator and the main circuit breaker are identical? That's how they should be. And then look at the circuit breaker for the air handling unit. Can you guys see that right here? And look at the curve for the air handling unit. Okay, so what does that mean? This is the starting current for the air handling unit. These two curves are not touching each other. Right here is the only place where these two circuit breakers are touching each other. This will not coordinate. Everywhere else is they're coordinated. So do me a favor. For the air handling unit, click on this curve, that curve here, and go to settings. Click on settings. Everybody's okay with that? And drag. Can you guys see that leg? You can't drag that leg more. Can't drag that leg more. Can you see how it moves this way? Or move it all the way to the left as much as you can. Now look at my circuit breaker is way far. I could probably gotten away with a smaller circuit breaker than that. Can you guys see that? I could have gotten away with a smaller circuit breaker and still good protection. Now go click on the main circuit breaker and push it all the way as far as you can get. Push it all the way as far as you can get, guys, the circuit breaker. Push it to the left as far as you can get. Can you guys see that? There are two circuit breakers here. So push it to the left as far as you can get. Cool? Now, there is coordination between all these curves. When would they not coordinate if they touch each other? If any of these curves is touching each other, you have no coordination. Where are they touching each other? Oops. I screwed it up here. Where are they touching each other, guys? Right in here. This is where they're touching each other. Can you guys see that? We at the bottom here. This is miscoordination here. You're going to live with this. There's nothing you can do about it. You're going to live with it. This miscoordination. Okay? All right. So now, that's curve number one. Do me a favor. Before you leave, go run. Can you guys see where it says run? Run TCC report. Everybody can see that. I need a report for it. Run TCC report. It tells you here's what the report is going to look like. And hit OK. And accept all the defaults. And hit OK. And where do you want to save it? It opens that area where you can save it here. And hit save. Here's your report that you need to print for your friend chat. What the report will show you, guys, it will show you all the information that you did. It's a thermal curve, 500 amp, instantaneous high, and set all the settings for the circuit breaker that you have. Click X out of this report, the lower X. Now, when I ask you, Adam, to print this curve for me, because I want you to print, not now, you're going to go to print. Here you go, print 11x17 at the printer. Okay? When I ask you to print the report, gentlemen, that we just did, you go to reports. Reports are right here. Text. All your reports are right here. And here's the one that we've just did. Open it. And here's your report. And you should be able to print your report. Okay? That's how you print. You are to print these two reports for your friend, Chad. Cool? X out of this curve right at the bottom here. Can you guys see that little X out of that curve? And let's go do one more curve. Shall we? Go click somewhere else so you can deselect what we have just selected. I'm going to do one more curve, Karen. Hit Control again and pick the generator circuit breaker, the main circuit breaker, as well as the chiller. Can you guys see the chiller? Two circuit breaker. And, let's start with chiller one, Chad. Generator, main, hold the control button, and the main circuit breaker, and chiller one circuit breaker, and chiller. Can you guys, when you're done picking these, can you give me a thumbs up? We picked this. This is the second coordination I want to make sure that chiller is coordinated with its circuit breaker and is coordinated with the two circuit breakers ahead of it. Adam, look what I'm going to do. Are you good? I'm going to go ahead this one again. This time, I'm going to call this a CU-1. That's coordination for the chiller. Chiller 1. Hit new. Gentlemen, you get a very similar curve. Remember how it's screwed up at the bottom here? Go settings. Can you guys see that? TCC, and add a zero to scale it. Add a zero right here to scale it. and hit OK. Now here's my curves. All my curves are here. I would like you guys to go to settings. Click on settings. Okay. Grab your MP curve and put it at the top. Go to generator, put it right underneath it. Go to the circuit breaker for the chiller right here. And the chiller itself right here. Now, Adam, look what happened. Can you guys see that every time you start your chiller, Karen, your circuit breaker will trip? Can you guys see that here? That's miscoordination. Meaning when you start your chiller, the circuit breaker will see this one as a short circuit and will trip because they're overlapping. So how am I going to solve this? Click on the circuit breaker here, guys, and settings. And can you guys see where sit low, Adam? The instantaneous is sit low. I'm going to go sit the instantaneous at, instead of low, go set it to 3. It moves it slightly. Can you guys see that? You can set it to 2. Probably 2 is the best. Can you guys see that? One more time. Now I'm focusing on the settings of the instantaneous to coordinate. Here's my option. Look at this. I can go low and overlap and it will trip. I can go very high. Click on high. They don't overlap. What's wrong with high? Too high. Too high is dangerous because the arc flash will be very high. So you want it to be close to the curve, but not overlap. Very close, but not overlap. So Derek, let's go back from, instead of very high, let's go to, this is overlapping. I can't do that. I want to go to 2. Can you guys see that 2 gave me barely coordinated? They're not touching, but very close to each other. That's the best that you can get. Gentlemen, you have good coordination here, right in this area. Oops, I'll click on that. Now I'm going to go run the report. Karen, the same thing, run. Can you guys see run TCC report? The name of the report is going to be CU1. Keep it and okay it. And it's going to put it in these reports, save it. It will open it for you, and you're going to print it for your friend Chad when I say print. Now for the time being, go exit, please. And X out of this curve as well. That's the second one that we're going to do. One more, and then we're done. The third one, you probably guys can do it. Let's go do it together. Pick the generator. Pick the main. Pick the chiller number 2. Chiller 2. Pick the chiller 2 and its circuit breaker. Everybody got that? Go to the coordination curve. Call it CU-2. Hit new, hit yes, open it. Now do you see how it need to be scaled? Click on settings, TCC, add the 0 to scale it. Now it's scaled perfectly. Rearrange the circuit breakers from the beginning, main circuit breaker, generator circuit breaker, chiller 2 circuit breaker, as well as chiller 2. Now Adam, can you see that we have a miscoordination here? Same thing, miscoordination here. So what are you going to do? For the chiller, click on the green circuit breaker for chiller 2. Click on settings. Do you guys see it sit at low here? The instantaneous sit at low. What does low means? Low means is the most protection. High means is the least protection. So, but I can't have the most protection because it will trap. So what are you going to do? Let's go set it at 2. Can you guys see now that's as good as it can get? You can also adjust it by doing it this way. Can you guys see dragging it? You can drag it this way. So this is way too high. I'm going to drag it back. So the best way to do it is to come over here and set it at 2. Can you guys see that? Now my instantaneous is set at 2. It coordinates with the starting curve of the chiller. With the starting curve of the chiller, good to go. It's coordinating with the main circuit breaker. The only miscoordination that I have, Adam, and I have to live with, is right in this area, right here. Can you guys see that? And this area here is all hell break loose. All hell break loose, and I can live with all of it. That could happen 0.1% of the time. Okay. Only 3 have a very, very short, high short circuit. I can live with that. I can do the only way you can solve this problem if you have an adjustable instantaneous electronic, and that will be very expensive solution. Okay, we're done here. Go run, same thing, run TCC, okay it again, and save your file. Here's what you're going to print for your friend Chad. And this report that you guys are looking at, if you can see, it tells you all the information that you have done. For example, it will tell you, here's this circuit breaker's generator. It's connected to bus 005. Its function phase, square D, is the manufacturer. And the type is 300 to 600. The type is LC. Interrupting rating is 1,000. The frame is LC 240 500 amp. It's sitting at 500 amp. Its thermal curve, its instantaneous is set at high. That's all what you need for Adam, for an electrician, to grab their screwdriver and go to the face of the circuit breaker and start adjusting these circuit breakers in the field. That's what you're telling them. If you don't adjust these circuit breakers, they will trip. They would not coordinate. So, gentlemen, welcome to the coordination. That's what coordination is all about. I know you're going to be presenting about that one. So, exit out of this. Let me go, please, and exit out of that. So, when I tell you to print these guys, very easy. You come over here, print them. So, exit out of it again. So, to summarize, guys, we did coordination for three curves. Karen, if you want to go back to these curves, find them. Where would you find these curves? Can you guys click here? Don't have anything highlighted. Just click here. Here's all the three curves that we did. So, say, Adam, I want to go look at CU1. Click on CU1 and double-click on it. It opens it for you. And always exit that one. Here's your curve. Done with it. Exit it. You guys see how you can get at any one of them by clicking here, all your curves. Make sure you save. Do me a favor. One last thing. Run. When you are in the riser, go run. Run balance studies. Okay? And run it. Run your balance studies again. There's one warning here. What was that warning? Did you guys get one warning?
No.
Fatal error. There's some. Okay. You guys got fail error? There's something that's not connected. Okay. Anybody else got fail error?
No, I didn't get it, but when I went to edit errors,
yeah.
It's not showing me.
Yep. Let me see it one more time. Run. Balance studies. And okay. Close. I don't have any of these. Can you rerun again, guys? Rerun again, will you? Nothing yet. The same thing happened to me. I think there is a bug in the software. Rerun again, will ya? Because we didn't do a whole lot. Thank you. Can I get the camera, please? We're going to field trip today. Can you charge it? I'll swing by at 10:15 and get it for you.
We might be open in the warrant building, but my
laptop doesn't
work anymore, so.
Oh. I'll be there. Yeah, thank you. Is it charged and empty?
It's empty, and I'll plug it in.
Can you plug it in for me? I really appreciate it. We're leaving it. Yep. I'll get it. Thank you. Okay, everybody got Karen? Was it good? Okay. Now we're going to run. I updated my short circuit calculation. That's what I did. Now I want you guys to run one more thing. The arc flash. Run arc flash evaluation. Now the arc flash will make sense because we have overcomputation device. Arc flash. Accept all the default and hit OK. Here's my arc flash calculation. Go to customer label. Can you guys see the customer label here? Click on customer label. Go preview. They're all of the labels are right in here, guys. I'm going to go continue. And here's the labels that you need to. Can you guys see the arc flash level? Right in here is PPE level. We have 00 gloves. It gives you the touch hazard and what's not. This is very, very small category, category zero here. Now that's the bottom one. Hold your horses. This is PPA level, non-melting, or so. A lot of them, guys, they're very simple, category zero. The last one is the worst, and I want you guys to see which one is that. Which, anybody remember which bus is that? This is main circuit, main termination box, the meter. Anybody knows why there is no PPE exists there? There is no circuit breaker ahead of it. There is no protection. So you're not supposed to work on this energized. Can you guys see that? So look at the arc flash boundary. It's 348 joule per centimeter squared, a huge amount. Do not work on it live. Can you guys see that? Do not work on it live, meaning you have to de-energize to work on this piece of equipment. That's where Excel comes. That's your termination box. You have to ask Excel to go shut down that transformer before you work on it. So Adam, when you're done with this, you're going to go ahead, print for your friend Chad, and basically print it as a PDF and put it in the network. Okay? Close out of it. Close again. How do you get into it again? You go back again to run and TCC curve, arc flash, and good to go. The last thing I'm going to show you guys is where you put your reports. All your reports are right here. Click on this little, one more time. Click on this little icon here. Here's all your reports right in here. All your curves are right in here. Here's all your curves. Either you get them from here or you can also get them from here. One-line diagrams. All your one-line diagrams. We only have all your one-line diagrams, guys, are right in here. Oops. My one-line diagrams are right in here. The mean and what's not. All your one-line diagrams are right here. Okay. So the last thing, what do you need to do from this software after you massage it a little bit? I would like you guys to print all these items. The one-line diagram 11 by 17, short circuit report, input report, load flow report, coordination curve 1 and report, coordination curve CU2 and report, an air handling unit and report. Remember the report that we ran? And the arc flash labels. Now, how hard is that? Now, you guys are experts in SKM Power Tools for Windows. I know the devil's in the details, guys. You know how to run the software. How to interpret these, it will come with time. Cool? Any comments, guys? Any questions? Comments, questions? So in 2 hours, you were able to run a short circuit, arc flash, and coordination curves. The most important, what I'm focusing right now, is the ability to use the software. The ability to interpret these reports, guys, will focus more in the industrial project. I know you're going to be presenting on SOU and I will sit. Okay. Any comments, gentlemen? Any questions? That's all I have. Thank you.